Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Welcome to Dominion Church International. We are a church that is committed to the word, worship, and witnessing. My name is Julian Cheyne, and I'll be taking you through the weekly schedule. It is an honor to have you joining us for church online through our social media platforms, that is Facebook and YouTube at Dominion Church International Mbuya. On Tuesdays, we have Bible study with our resident pastor, Pastor John Bazira, that is from 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. He is teaching about the book of Revelations. Come and hear what the Spirit of the Lord is speaking to the churches. The word that is for the season, let us know of it. Let us breathe it. Hallelujah. And on Fridays, we have the Holy Ghost Revival lunch hour. That is from 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. Reverend Robert Kaziwe and the Dominion family are here praying for you, praying for your relatives, praying for our nation. Log in, send in your prayer requests. Let us pray together as one so that we shall be bound in cords that cannot be broken. And on Sunday, like today, we have our service that is from 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. with Reverend Robert Kaziwe. He is breaking down the word for us. Come, be built up in the word. Be edified. Don't forget to share that link. Share it with your friends. Share it with your neighbors, your enemies, so they can listen to the word of God and be edified. Now, let us welcome the Dominion Praise Ministries to take us through praise and worship.
Hallelujah, everybody. Praise the Lord. We want to welcome you here today on this day. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we are going to praise the Lord. We are going to rejoice in the Lord, because He is our protector. He is our defender. He is our deliverer. He is the lifter of our heads. Come on, shout hallelujah. Swalabirida, obulamu bwange.
Sinza kumureka, yeswalabirida, obulamu bwange.
Sinza kumureka, yeswalabirida, obulamu
bwange.
Sinza kumureka, yeswalabirira, obulamu bwange.
For you, that each and everything we need
for you. Our worship belongs to you. Our praise belongs to you. My hands are for you. I am your vessel. I am your vessel. I am this treasure in the earthen vessel. God, I thank you. And I surrender myself to you. I give away my pain. I give away my worship. I give away my praise. I give away everything. I lay down my crown unto you, the King of glory. You are the King that is worshipped by all kings. Hallelujah, hallelujah. For there is no one like. Myself away. Oh my God. I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. You are my comforter. You are my redeemer. Give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. Salabakosi, legalabadante kosi, lebantaya. I give myself away. So you can you. To give myself away to your will, to your call, to your call.
Give myself away
that you may use me. Here I am, I'm standing in your presence. Give myself away.
I give myself away.
Lord, use me, Lord.
So you.
somebody lift your voice and say, we say, Sakabatana, the gold sent him. Our answered worship is yes, Lord. Our answered worship is yes, Lord. Thank you.
Bangurira mukwe, bangurira mukwe, bangurira 23.
The Bible opens us to the understanding that we have a Father. We have a Lord of our lives. Not only is Lord of our lives, but the Bible tells us is our shepherd. The one that makes sure that we have the food that we need. The one that makes sure that he finds pasture for us. So in Psalms 23, the Bible begins by saying, The Lord is my shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. My shepherd is the Lord. The Lord is my shepherd. And my shepherd is the Lord. And the word Lord means the one that possesses all things. The one that knows all things. The one that controls all things. The possessor of the heavens and the earth. He is our shepherd. But from the psalm we read that you have to make him a personal shepherd, a personal Lord. The Lord is my shepherd. Not our shepherd, but my shepherd. Can you say that with me? The Lord is my shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. Can you say that again? The Lord is my shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. My shepherd is Lord. Isn't that wonderful? My shepherd is Lord. Is Lord over the heavens and is Lord over the earth. My shepherd is the Lord.
It
is like saying my father is the
president.
So the Lord is our shepherd. But our shepherd is also the Lord. Did you get that, beloved? When the Lord is your shepherd, it simply means your shepherd is the Lord. Let me say it again. When the Lord is your shepherd, that means your shepherd is the Lord. The Lord is my shepherd, but my shepherd is the Lord. And because my shepherd is the Lord, I shall not want. Because he knows where the pasture is, and he owns the pasture. Because the Bible tells us that heaven and earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, and the people that dwell therein. And then he goes on to tell you, ask of me then, and I shall give thee the heathen for thy inheritance, and the uttermost parts of the earth. The Lord is my shepherd. My shepherd is the Lord. Therefore I shall not want. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you for being our shepherd and our Lord, our guide, our mercy, our comfort, our provider, and our Father. We honor you today. We pray in the name of Jesus that you will bless your people. We pray in the name of Jesus that you will lead them in the paths of righteousness for your name's sake. We pray in the name of Jesus that you will prepare a table before them in the presence of their enemies. We pray in the name of Jesus. Allow your goodness and your mercy to follow them all the days of their lives. Thank you for your grace and your anointing right now. And in the name of Jesus, we submit to your spirit. We submit to you, the bishop of our souls. We submit to you, our Lord. And everything that will be said be glorified. In the name of Jesus. Everybody say amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Once again, we want to welcome each and every one of you that is watching. And I believe God is blessing you because we pray before we come on the air. And we are praying every day that the words that God will allow you to speak to you will become a great, great, great encouragement. That through the words that God gives us to speak, faith will be cultivated in your heart. And you will rise to be the man and the woman that God wants you to be. In the mighty name of Jesus. And I believe with everything within me that the goodness of God is going to come to you today. Let me say that again. I believe with everything within me that the goodness of God is going to come to you today. In the name of Jesus. If you have a Bible with you, I want you to go to the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 1. 2 Corinthians chapter 1. 2 Corinthians chapter 1. And we're reading from verses 1. The Bible says verses 1. Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ, by the will of God, and Timothy, our brother, unto the church of God which is at Corinth, with all the saints which are in all Achaia. Here in this scripture, there is a writer by the name Paul. So he introduces himself to us as a representative of Christ. And then he introduced to us another servant by the name Timothy. He says, not only me, but also Timothy is a servant of the Lord. And we want to talk to the church of God, which is at Corinth. The church of God, which is at Corinth. The property of God, which is at Corinth. We want you to know, you Corinthians, you don't belong to you. You belong to God. You are His church, bought by the blood of my Son Jesus, sanctified in Christ. I want you to know, you are the church of God. You are the property of God. You belong to God. You are in God. You are not your own. You are His church. Paul and Timothy writing to the church of the living God. Many times we forget that we are not our own, but we belong to God. And the God we belong to is the Almighty God.
He
is a great and mighty God. He is the possessor of the heavens and the earth. And He is a creator as well. He is not a creation. All power belongs to Him. All authority belongs to Him. All grace belongs to Him. He is all knowing. He knows the end from the beginning. And so He knows what will happen millions of years from now. One day He spoke to Abraham
and
says, Abraham, I want you to know, from now, 450 years later, your grandchildren will be brought back to this land from Egypt. So God was telling Abraham, I know what's going to happen in the next 450 years. And I'm telling you, this is what will happen. And so when the Bible tells us that the church belongs to God, the church must know that there is nothing that takes God by surprise. There is nothing about your life and about your journey and about your destiny that will take God by surprise. In fact, according to Psalms 139, the Bible tells us that everything about you was written in a book before you were born. The Bible tells us in the book of Jeremiah chapter 1, God spoke to Jeremiah and said, before I formed you in your mother's womb, I knew you. And before you came out, I gave you an assignment. So I know your assignment before you were born, and I allowed you to be born because of that assignment. And I know the difficulties, I know the challenges, I know the pain. But I want you to know, Jeremiah, if you stand with me and you stay with me and you stay on course, you will make it. You will arrive to your destiny. Because there's nothing I don't know about you. The church of God which is at Corinth. The church of God which is at Mbuya. The church of God which is in Uganda. The church of God around the world belongs to God. The all-knowing God. The almighty God. He knew that 2020 there will be COVID. He knew what's happening right now. Before the earth was created. And therefore, child of God, take heart. COVID will not end this world. COVID doesn't have the last say. There is a God that we belong to that has the final say. I'm hearing the child of God. And it doesn't matter whether all of us sleep in the Lord. Somehow, God will reserve a remnant. There will be a people that God will keep alive. And I believe that I will be kept alive. And I believe you will be kept alive. I believe the mercies of God will watch over your life wherever you are. In the name of Jesus, I hearing me, child of God. Paul and Timothy writing to the church of the living God which is at Corinth, writing to the church of God which is in Uganda. Well, we keep on hearing all the sad news and all the bad news and all the ugly news. The other day somebody wrote on WhatsApp and said, now Bishop so and so is gone. What is going to happen to us? What's going to happen next? How about God's people? Listen to me, child of God. We don't belong to ourselves. We belong to God. The Bible says in the book of Acts of the Apostles, chapter 19, that we are bought by the blood of Jesus. Are you hearing me, beloved of God? In chapter 20, bought by the blood of Jesus. You are bought by the blood of Jesus. Sanctified by the blood of Jesus. You don't belong to anybody else. And even if you are to die, the Bible says you belong to God. Whether you live, you belong to God. And so we are here to remind ourselves that there's nothing that is happening that God doesn't know about. And because God knows about what is happening right now, He knows the outcome. And the Bible tells us in the book of Jeremiah that I know the plans for you. They are plans to prosper you. They are plans to give you a best end, a good end. And then you will call upon me and I will answer. Are you hearing me, child of God? God knows your life from the beginning, your end from the beginning. You will make it. In the name of Jesus, there will be a remnant that will stay to proclaim the words of God in the name of Jesus. And I believe I'm going to be one of them. And I believe you will be one of them. I believe the church will testify. You know, when you get your Bible and read in the book of Revelation, you will see one tragedy, one pain, one challenge, one death after the other. To the extent that the Bible tells us that there was a time when almost three quarters of the oceans were dried up and the world was filled with woe. But again, at the end of the day, there remained a people to testify of the goodness of God, because God knows knows the end from the beginning. And so God wants us to know that the church is here to stay. That COVID will not outlast the church. That whether 20 pastors die or live, God is able to raise stones to testify. If there is a need for stones to testify, but they will be a remnant. They will be men and women of God that will stay. And I trust that everyone that hears the sounding of my voice will make it in the name of Jesus. Are you hearing me, child of God? Then he goes on to say verses 2. Grace unto you and peace from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. He goes on to verse 3 and says, blessed be God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all comfort, who comforts us in all our tribulation, that we may be able to comfort them which are in any trouble by the comfort wherewith ourselves are comforted. Now, I don't know if you really understood the words I've just read to you. But let me try to explain to you a little bit. The Bible says, number one, that God will give you grace and God will give you peace. God will give you grace and God will give you peace. But he goes on to tell us that blessed be God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all comfort. The Father of mercies, the Father of mercies and the God of all comfort. God's mercy is healing mercy. But on top of mercy, he has all the comfort you need. And the Bible goes on to say, who will always comfort us in all our tribulation. The next verse I've said, that he will comfort us in all our tribulation. He will comfort us in all our tribulation. Child of God, I came by to tell you that you are and comfortness will be over in the name of Jesus. And they are over in the name of Jesus. Because we have a God who owns the church, who is also the Father of mercies, but also the God of all comfort, who comforts us in all. So as much as there is suffering, God wants you to know there is comfort at the same time. He is not the author of suffering. He is not the one that brought the suffering. But because of the enemy, the devil, who is the enemy of our soul, suffering is here. But as much as there is suffering here, the God of mercies and the God of all comfort is going to comfort us in all our comfortness. In every place of your life where you have been discomforted by pain, discomforted by worry, discomforted by sickness, discomforted by bad news, discomforted by people, discomforted by pain, all the discomfort, God is bringing comfort to you in the name of Jesus. There is comfort for you. There is comfort for me. Out of all your discomfortness, out of all my discomfortness, I want you to know there is comfort for you. God will comfort you in all your discomfortness, with all your discomfortness. So can I suggest to you, the child of God, raise your hands and begin to give him praise, because comfort is on the way. God is going to comfort you from every discomfort. And he also promised us in the book of John chapter 15, verses 26, 27 and 28, talking about the Holy Ghost. And he calls him many names, but there's a name he calls the Holy Spirit. He calls him Comforter. 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 Beloved, we are not just waiting for the Comforter, but the Comforter is here. The Comforter is in your heart. The Comforter is in your spirit. The Comforter is in that room where you are suffering. And God will allow the Holy Spirit to comfort you, but at the same time he'll bring his mercy also, and he'll bring his comfort also, and so you'll have comfort within and you'll have comfort outside you. So there will be comfort for you, for the peace of your soul, for the peace of your mind, but also there will be comfort for you all around you in the name of Jesus. I want you to say with me, all my discomforts are over today in the name of Jesus. Say that again one more time. All my discomforts are over in the name of Jesus. Because the Comforter has come. The Father of all mercies here. And the God of all comfort is here to comfort me. In the name of Jesus. And the Bible goes on to say that therefore whether, verse 6, that whether we are afflicted, it is for your consolation and salvation, which is effectual in the enduring of the same suffering, which also we suffer. Or whether we be comforted, it is for the consolation and salvation. Verse 7, and our hope of you is steadfast, knowing that as you are partakers of the sufferings, so shall ye be also of the consolation. And then he goes on to tell them his testimony. Verses 8. For we would not, brethren, have you ignorant of our trouble, which came to us in Asia, that we were pressed out of measure, above strength, in so much that we despaired even of life. But we had the sentence of death in ourselves, that we should not trust in ourselves, but in God, which raises the dead, who delivered us from so great a death, and doth deliver, in whom we trust, that he will yet deliver us. Because he's the Father of mercies and is the God of all comfort. If you can stand wherever you can stand, I want you to stand. And I want you to raise your hands. And I want you to receive the comfort from
them.
I want you to know, trouble will not have the best half of your life. I want you to know that discomfort will not last forever. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray that release comfort upon your people. Release them from every discomfort. Every discomfort of the mind, every discomfort of the spirit, every discomfort of their body, every discomfort in their finances, let your comforting hand comfort them. Bind every wound. The Bible tells us you are a balm in Gilead. Therefore, you, the balm of
Gilead,
heal them in the name of Jesus. You are a healing Jesus. Arise with healing in your spirit, in your wings. And from their heads up to the soles of their feet, let them be healed in the name of Jesus. Let them be comforted in the name of Jesus. Let every emotional stress and every emotional distress be removed from them. Heal them now. Heal them now. Give them your peace. Give them your comfort. In the name of Jesus, I give you praise for every miracle. I give you praise for every healing. I give you praise for every comfort. I bless you. Now raise those hands. I want you to take a few moments to thank him. Just give him praise. Just give him glory. Just give him honor for what God is doing right now in your life. Comfort has come. Healing has come. It is well with your soul. It is well with your mind. It is well with your body. It is well with your life. It is well. 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 In that mighty name of Jesus. Whatever, my Lord,
come on.
Whatever, my Lord, has taught me to say,
it is well, it is well with my soul.
well.
It is well. My soul, oh, it is well
with my soul,
it is well
with my life.
My soul, let's declare that one more time. It is well,
it is well,
it is well,
it is well
with my soul, with my soul. It is well. It is well with my soul.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Get your offering. Father, in the name of Jesus, we bless your people. We bless their offering that has come out of deep, deep, deep sacrifice. I pray that they will reap one of the most miraculous harvests in their lives. In their lives. Bless their businesses. Bless everything they touch. And we bless them as they give. In Jesus' name. The number is on your screen where you can sow your seed. But still, you can also come to church. The church office is always open, where you can give your tithes and your offering. We love you. And would ask you, please, keep hope alive. Keep praying for the church. Keep lifting up the name of Jesus. Keep faith alive. If you have not yet joined our media platforms, please do so. And God will bless you and encourage you through the messages that we minister through those platforms. Until we meet again, this is Pastor Robert Kaziwe, the senior pastor of Dominion Church, and my interpreter, minister. We love you. God bless you. In Jesus' name. Give thanks
because
He's given.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus.